And we have. Gala Shrine, Marsh Flats. Gala Shrine, Marsh Flats. That's basically it. I mean, all this other stuff doesn't really matter. Like, all this dust. Really just want to fix our mana. And we can worry about win conditions later on. So, what does Marsh Flats get? Well, Godless Shrine is actually just on color. Marsh Flats right now gets Tundra, Blood Crypt. Overrun Tomb doesn't count, and not Steven. So Tundra and Blood Crypt. So it gets everything. And I think I almost want to get that. At the same time, let's see. Godless Shrine, we've got Pearl Ruby, Golgari Signet. How much black are we playing? Eh, we can just go with the Godless Shrine. We'll just keep on going with that option. And hopefully we wheel something sweet. Ooh, Coalition Relic. Mox Jett. So probably taking Mox Jett. And we can be fine wheeling any creature out of here. Wheeling Coalition Relic. So we've got three of the Moxes and the Lotus. Passed on Time Twister and Time Walk. So, God. Potentially three more power. This pack is quite mediocre. We could take a Simic Sky Swallower, Wrath of God, Mox Diamond. I don't really like Mox Diamond in this deck because they're just going to end up running very few lands, so Mox Diamond is not going to be as useful. Still, we might just take it in any case, just because Simic Sky Swallower is not really that great. We could play it pretty easily, actually. We do have an Overgrown Tomb, which we would play in that case, and a Golgari Signet and a Selesnya Signet. I think that's pretty close. I actually think that this is a pretty reasonable guy to run as a win condition. We actually want that. I think I'm just going to take this Mox Diamond and find something better. Ooh, Ralzerac? Is that good? Gargadon's pretty sweet, but I think I just want to take Ral. I like Ral. I've definitely had a lot of trouble from this guy, and so I'm very happy when I see him generally. Other cards are pretty boring, except for Greater Gargadon with Balance. That's pretty sweet. But I'm just going to take this Ralzerac. Wow. Tezzeret, Agent of Bolas? Yeah, that's pretty good. What else is there? Let's see. Yeah, now we don't actually need any creatures to win with. So we have Lotus, Mox Diamond, Jett, Pearl Ruby, Mana Vault. So yeah, we just have a ton of artifacts. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, this guy's going to be awesome. Definitely play with that. Maybe we can wheel the Abyss. And right now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, probably not playing Dream Halls. And Siege Commander, Koth, Fact or Fiction, Tendrils, Sphinx, Steemoggery versus Dwar Isle. Ooh. I'm not really too much of a fan of Steemoggery, whereas Sphinx of Dwar Isle is pretty reasonable just because it has shrouds, so it's pretty hardy. It's not going to die very easily except to something like Wrath of God. I haven't really been too impressed with Steemoggery. It's just, I mean, it's okay, but I like Sphinx a little bit more. Ooh, Talarian Academy, you say? It's either that or Dreadbore. That's kind of close. And by close, I mean I'm taking Talarian Academy because goodness gracious. Ooh, Emrakul versus Trinket Mage. Trinket Mage is awesome in this deck. Versus Yogg-Wheel. This is actually pretty tough, I think. I think this is actually something that's pretty good, except Trinket Mage gets Lotus, Mox Diamond, Jett, Pearl Ruby, so pretty much everything. Yeah, I'm just gonna take that. That's sick. Now we can take Deluge versus Chandra. Chandra copies Wheel of Fortune, Faithless Looting, Agony Warp. Not too much. Toxic Deluge is like a Wrath of God, which I suppose it would be happy with. Not sure how much I like either of these cards, but I think I'm just going to go with the Deluge. And here we can go with Wildfire, I guess. Maybe the Chancery? No. Lodestone Golem? That would be pretty sweet, although how many of these spells are we actually going to be casting? Might be better just to play something like Thornscape Battlemage or Wildfire. I can definitely see Wildfire being good. We don't have too many lands. I'm just going to go with the Wildfire. And now I guess we can take this Nightscape Familiar. Don't have too many blue or black cards. Blue or red, rather. We have Wildfire, Siege King, Commander Koth, Wheel of Fortune, Firebolt, Faith Slitting, Ralzarek. It blocks and regenerates versus Razorbane Manticore. And don't really want to play either. I guess I'm just going to take the Nightscape Familiar. And an Inquisition. We could play that. The Abyss. Ooh. I'll definitely play the Abyss. This really doesn't work with the Sphinx, but yeah, whatever. Magus of the Moon or Lake of the Dead? Well, since we'll probably be playing with very few lands, I'm going to take the Magus. So yeah, I'm going to lay everything out and see where we are, and hopefully everything ends up working out. Alrighty, so here are the spells that I'm interested in running. You can see that there are 27. I don't have any of the Moxes over here yet. I guess the Mox Diamond should count as a spell and not a land, because you need a land to make it work. So I want to be able to cut, I want to cut five of these cards, and immediately we can take a look and see that there's a lot of white here, but we have Catastrophe and Balance. Those are the two cards. I actually want to play the Balance. I'm just not sure on the Catastrophe yet, just because double white's gonna be sort of difficult. But we do have Lotus, Pearl, Trinket Mage, Mox Diamond, and Selesnya Signet. So that should end up being enough. We also have Tundra, Thawing Glaciers, and Godless Shrine. So to a certain extent, the white services are technically free, and it's only at the point where we actually have to run a basic planes that we really need to question whether or not we should be doing that. Although I feel if we're playing Thawing Glaciers, we should be playing planes. So moving onward, you can see if we want to cut, if you want to cut spells, you have to take a look at stuff like Koth of the Hammer. Exactly how often are we actually going to be able to be using this guy? And we're base red, so that'll probably be good enough, but Koth in this deck is not nearly as impressive as other decks. Although having the option of untapping an opposing mountain and then playing Wildfire is pretty sweet. Or having Catastrophe to kill creatures. And so we end up having stuff like Brain Freeze, Agony Warp, Firebolt. Those are cards that I'm less interested about playing. Same thing with Siege King Commander, Nightscape Familiar. Just because with Balance, Catastrophe, Toxic Deluge, playing creatures kind of sucks. So if we take out those and just run Sphinx of Jor-El, Etched Oracle, Trinket Mage, and Glenelinger Archmage, and then take out, okay, we can keep Firebolt. If we take out Agony Warp and maybe Koth. Let's see where we are now. We've got three Signets. Is it Golgari and Selesnya, Mana Vault? Probably just need, and we could, I don't think we actually need to run Mox Diamond. We're going to end up having so few lands, I think. It's pretty close, though. So we're going to be running about 1, 2, 3, maybe 13 lands. So Mox Diamond ends up being kind of shaky. I do like it with Balance, though, so I think I'll probably end up running this. And it's good with Etched Oracle. So cards on the cusp are like Brain Freeze. I think I'd rather, I'm not sure between Brain Freeze and Koth. I think I'd probably just rather run Koth. But we've got Wheel, Ral, Tez, the Abyss, those are all good. Wildfire, Catastrophe, Nicol Bolas. Yeah, I like all of these. So the question is, do we want to run another land? Or do you want to run a Koth? Because I think it's the last slot is Koth. I don't care about Siege getting Commander at all. And I might not want Sphinx either, but Sphinx is pretty robust. It sucks with the Abyss though. But I think I want to try and play that. So if we end up just running these spells and then 13 lands, that should be good. 13 lands, you say. I think we'll just skip on this Koth or skip on the Sphinx. So taking a look at the lands that we've got a Jet. We have a Pearl, we have a Ruby, so figuring out the rest of our colors. Let's say we have Thawing Glaciers here, we have Tolarian Academy for blue. So if we have blue over here, and let's just do this. Blue here, Thawing Glaciers, Lotus, we've got blue red. I'm not going to be running Overgrown Tomb, just another pain land. We don't have any green except for Etched Oracle, but I think we'll be fine. We have a Godless Shrine to overlap here. We have a Blood Crypt to overlap here. We have a Tundra to overlap on this far end. So we've got one, two, three, four. Four sources of blue, and we'll probably be running the Shivan Reef also. So let's see where we are for land. Okay, 3-3-3-1. If we're plane thawing, I definitely want to play one planes. So this looks like it could be okay. We've got red as one red, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven sources. Eight sources. Probably good enough. This looks fine, so we'll just try this, I think, and take a quick look. One, two, three. So that's three, four, five, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah, let's just try this. So I'm gonna see, I'll submit this and then see you in round one. Should be pretty awesome.